CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So friends, let's join in Dhwani Shala class 5.
Hello everyone. How are you all? I hope all of you are fine and excited as well for today's session. Once again, I, Gitanjali from GSKV number 1 Model Town 3rd Delhi is taking chapter 1st of class 5. The name of the chapter is The Fish Tale. This is episode number 4 and we are going once again into the life of fishermen and the sea. Till now, you must have had dreams of sea and the fishermen for sure. Some of you must have imagined yourself on the seashore traveling in your choice of boat. So, which boat you like to travel and which boat you would like to buy for fishing? Do you think it is easy to live the life of a fisherman? In my last session, I have asked you to think and find out more about the life of fishermen. What kind of problems they used to face in sea while fishing for their livelihood. Many fishermen cannot even buy their own boat, while some of the fishermen can have trawlers. The fishermen having trawlers must be the big businessmen. So, it is obvious that they have a huge amount of money to buy such a big machine. I think the big machine must cost big amount. Can you guess the big amount? Try. I hope you can actually guess the correct amount. Only if you know how to read the big numbers. So let's first start reading the big numbers. This is our objective today, that we will be learning how to read the big numbers. Some of you must have remembered about the term lakh, which you have read in your class 4 maths book. Yes, the lakh, which is actually equal to 100 thousands. Do you know how to write 1000? It's 1000. 3 zeros after 1. So, can you name the place of all these zeros? Yes, it is ones, tens, 100 from the right, and 1 is at the thousands place. The number is 1000, which is read as 1000. And now, we have a new term, lakh, which is equal to 100,000. Can we write this number 1 lakh? So let us try. 100,000. Then it is 1 lakh. So how many zeros are there in 1 lakh? Let us count from your right. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So, there are 5 zeros in 1 lakh. And now, you know the name of the places as well. It is ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000 and lakh. Okay, try to recall the situation where you have heard about the numbers in lakh. You might have heard about the numbers in lakh in your classroom. Nowadays, you must be listening the number in lakhs about the COVID patients. So, my question is, Ranjan earned 6 lakh in 1 year. Can you find out his income in 4 years? Now try and find out. Ranjan earns rupees 6 lakh in 1 year. So, in 2 years, his earning will be 6 lakhs 2 times. Similarly, he earns 6 lakhs 4 times in 4 years. So, can we multiply 6 lakh by 4? 6 lakh multiplied by 4 is equal to 24 lakh. Can you count the number of zeros in this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, there are 5 zeros after 24 and this is 24 lakh. Now, my next question for you is, suppose our country has 2 lakhs boat, out of which half of the boats are motor boats. So, can you find out the number of motor boats in our country? As you can see, total boats are 2 lakh. Half of 2 is 1. So, half of 2 lakh is 1 lakh. Isn't it easy? Yes. Hence, we can say that our country has 1 lakh motor boats. Try to write this 1 lakh in words also. You know, it is important to write the numbers in words as well as in numericals. Now, let's go for another question. If I say that out of the motor boats, 1/4 of the motor boats are big machine. Now, can you find out the exact number of motor boats but without writing on the paper? So, we have to find out 1/4 of motor boats that are machine boats, or you can say the trawlers. And the number of motor boats in India are 1 lakh. How do you know that? This is because in previous question we have said that number of motor boats in India is 1 lakh. Now we will find out 1/4 of 1 lakh. So we have to break 1 lakh in 4 equal parts. For this, I want to make it easy for you. As you know that 1 lakh is equal to 100 thousands. So now we can easily break 100 thousand. 100 in 4 equal parts. 100 in 2 equal part is 50 and 50. We can say 50,000 and 50,000. Now 50 will be further divided into 2 equal parts. 50 and 50 can be written as 25, 25, 25 and 25. So we have 25,000, 25,000, 25,000 and 25,000 as 4 equal parts of 1 lakh. Finally, the 1/4 of motor boat is the 4th part of 1 lakh, that is 25,000. So, the number of machine boats in our country is 25,000. Now, moving back to the fishermen and sea. Can you imagine the number of lives related to fish and the sea? Almost 100 lakh. 100 lakh? Yes, they catch fish, they clean them, they sell them. Some of the fishermen even make and repair the boats too. They make and repair the nets also. All these 100 lakh of people work day and night. This 100 lakh is surely bigger than 1 lakh. Yes, now you must be thinking of the bigger number that I used. 100 lakh. Can you try to write this bigger number? I find this easy. It's simple. Write 100 at the place of 1 in lakh. And then write 5 zeros. 100 makes 100. And writing 5 more zeros after 100, this will become 100, 00, 00, 00, and 0. So, count the number of zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now, 100 lakh has total 7 zeros. And the name we gave to this bigger number is crore. So, 100 lakh is equal to 1 crore. Now, write 1 crore again. 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. It has total 7 zeros. Can you separate zeros of 1000 and tell the number of thousands in 1 crore? If we separate last 3 zeros of 1 crore, what is the number on the left side? Read that number other than last 3 zeros. It is 10,000. 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. That is 10,000. So, the 1 crore is equal to 10,000. It's 10, 3 zeros and 3 zeros. So, 1 crore has total 7 zeros. I hope now you can easily write 1 crore, 2 crore, 3 crore and so on. Now think of the places where you have heard use of crore in day-to-day life. The easiest or the obvious one is the population of India. It's in crores. The population of India is more than 131 crore. Now I would like you to write the number in crore. But do not get confused in the zeros of the crore. So, now you can imagine the number of fishes in the big sea. It can be in crores. Write your estimated number of fish in the sea. You can write any number from bigger to smaller. So, now let's move to the fish market. After catching fishes, using various types of boats, the fisherman needs to sell them in the market. Now, I would share the experience of fish market. Have you ever been visited the fish market? If yes, then you must be aware of the fact that why this place is full of noise and crowd. So, it is called fish market. This place has a large number of fishes of almost all types. This place, which is called fish market, has lots of activities going on. Some fishermen's boats brought a large number of fishes. The fisherwomen kept shouting the price to sell their fishes. Let me tell you the price of various types of fish. Now suppose you are in the same fish market to buy some fish. The fisherwoman is telling you the price of various types of fish she has. For your help, you can also write the rate of fish in your notebook. So, you can also write the price along with the name of the fish. Please note down. Anima, shouting loudly. Come here, have these small size fish, the sardine, at 40 rupees per kilogram. The other woman, named Gracie, never so cheap, gets swordfish for rupees 60 per kg. Florama sells prawns at 150 rupees a kg. Karuthamma sells squid fish for rupees 50 per kg. Fazila is carrying one of the heaviest fish. She is carrying a big king fish. The king fish weighs 8 kilograms. So, can you imagine the cost of the whole fish? She sells the whole fish for rupees 1200. So now you have to remember the price of each type of fish, as I am going to ask you some question based on the cost of fish. For your help, you can write the name of fish and their cost per kilogram in the table. So you have 5 minutes to draw the table and write the names. In the first column, we have names of the fish. In second column, we have rates of fish per kilogram. Now, write down in your first column the names of fish. First, sardine. Second, swordfish. Third is prawns. Fourth, squid. And finally, the fifth number is kingfish. In the next column, you have to write the rate of fish per kilogram. So, the rate of sardine is 40 rupees. The rate of swordfish is 60 rupees. The rate of prawns is 150 rupees. The rate of squid fish is 50 rupees. And the whole kingfish is costing rupees 1200 for 8 kilograms. So, are you ready? Can we start? Let's have question number 1. At what price per kilogram Fazila sells the kingfish? Kingfish, as you all know, is a big fish and the total weight is 8 kilograms. So, as you know, the total weight the kingfish is 8 kilogram, and Fazila said that she would sell the whole fish for rupees 1200, which means that we need to make 1200 rupees in 8 equal parts, or we can say we need to divide 1200 rupees in 8 parts. So, if you know how to divide, you can easily calculate the answer. Some of you might have already done it. 1200 divided by 8 is equal to 150. That is 150 rupees per kilogram. So if you wish, we can do it in a different way too. Let us take out 100 from 1200. How many times? 8 times, as we have to calculate the price for 8 kilograms. 1200 minus 100 is equal to 1100. 1100 minus 100 is equal to 1000. 1000 minus 100 is equal to 900. 900 minus 100 is equal to 800. 800 minus 100 is equal to 700. 700 minus 100 is equal to 600. 600 minus 100 is equal to 500. And finally, 500 minus 100 is equal to 400. So we have taken out 100 8 times from 1200. Now we are left with rupees 400, as we have taken out 100 rupees 8 times. Let us now do it again for rupees 400. Any hints? Yes, 8 multiplied by 5 is equal to 40, as you know the table. So, we can take out rupees 50 from 400. Now 400 minus 50, how many times? 8 times. We can see that whole amount of 1200 is divided into 100 plus 50, that is 150 rupees for 1 kg of kingfish. Therefore, 1 kilogram of kingfish cost rupees 150. Now let's go for the next question. The question number 2. If Florima sells 10 kilograms of prawns today, now tell me how much money would she get for that? I think this is easy for you. Now let us check. Cost of 1 kilograms of prawns is rupees 150. So now we need to find out the cost of 10 kilograms. Can we simply say 150 rupees will come to Florima 10 times as she is selling 10 kilograms of prawns? So multiplying 150 with 10 would be the correct answer. So now 150 is multiplied by 10 is equal to 1500. So 10 kilograms of prawns are sold for rupees 1500. Multiplying any number by 10 is the easiest. How? Think about that. We are going for one more question. Gracie sells 6 kilograms of swordfish. Minnie earns as much as Gracie. Now, how many kilograms of ceradine will Minnie sell to earn equal to Gracie? Now, what we need to do? First of all, we need to find out the amount Gracie earns for 6 kilograms of swordfish. So cost of 1 kilogram of swordfish is rupees 60. Cost of 2 kilograms of swordfish is rupees 60 plus 60. Or you can say 2 times 60. So we can simply say the cost of 6 kilograms of swordfish will be 6 times of 60. So we can multiply 6 with 60 and the answer is 360 rupees. Hence, Gracie earns 360 rupees for 6 kilograms of swordfish. Now it's Minnie's turn. Minnie earns the same amount by selling ceradine fish. This means she sells ceradine for 360 rupees. And if the cost of 1 kilogram of ceradine is 40 rupees, let us distribute 360 rupees in equal share of 40 rupees. So we will be taking out 40 rupees from 360 rupees to make the shares. 360 minus 40 is equal to 320. 320 minus 40 is equal to 280 rupees. 280 minus 40 is equal to 240. Now 240 minus 40 is equal to 200. 200 minus 40 is equal to 160. 160 minus 40 is equal to 120. 120 minus 40 is equal to 80. 80 minus 40 is equal to 40. And finally, 40 minus 40 is equal to 0. So we can say that we have make the share of 40 equally and successfully. So 360 rupees can be distributed in 9 equal share. It means she must have sold 9 kilograms of ceradine fish. to get equal amount of Gracie. We can simply divide 360 by 40 to avoid the long calculation. Now 360 divided by 40 is equal to 9. As you know, the table of 4. So Minnie sells 9 kilogram of sardine fish to earn equal amount like Gracie. It's getting too tired to roam in fish market. Now let us go to our home and think about the fish and their price. Today we have learned about various types of fish in the market and their price. How the fisherwomen sell the fishes. I would like you to visit to a fish market to find out the cost of fish in the market. Ask your parents to help you. I hope you have enjoyed our fish market tour. Also, try to make more questions based on the cost of various fish. Keep practicing. Have a good day. Thank you.
Friends, you are just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production Assistant Amit Kumar. This series Dhwani Shala was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And this program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.